So Adidas and Gucci, they're back for round two. But before we get into that, I found something very interesting that actually leads into that. Forget Yeezys. Adidas' new CEO says Sambas and Gazelles are the hottest shoe in the market. So it reads, the Adidas Yeezy business is gone, minus the remaining inventory worth $1.3 billion in sales at the sportswear giant has yet to shed. Adidas Sambas, Gazelles, and Special sneakers, what the company calls terrace shoes, are having a moment. We currently have maybe the hottest shoe in the market in the segment we call terrace, and it's the Samba. CEO Bjorn Gilden told analysts, I think it's something that if we manage it correctly, can be millions and millions of pairs, Gilden told analysts, and it's the first test to see if we can manage now a new franchise in the right way by keeping it alive, heating it up every quarter without over distributing it. So yes, Adidas, they definitely have a hit here with the Samba. They've done a few great things in terms of collaborations and kind of bringing some attention to this classic silhouette. And I know this may sound blasphemous, but I feel like in 2023, the Samba has surpassed the Superstar as the quintessential classic OG Adidas sneaker. And it looks like Adidas definitely knows what they have. And it looks like the new CEO will be going forward with a new approach. So could this model potentially make up for the $1 billion in losses that Adidas could face by ending this Yeezy partnership? I'm not so sure on that, but I definitely feel like the Samba is a great looking shoe. And it looks like Adidas, unfortunately, will be probably limiting this sneaker moving forward. It's only a consequence of the sneaker market and culture and TikTok and all that. I kind of look at it as like a Nike Dunk Low Panda situation. If something gets so played out and meme in popular culture, it starts to have a negative impact. And I feel like with the popularity that the Samba is gaining, it could reach a point of oversaturation. So I feel like it is a good business standpoint to maybe limit and make these releases just a little more special. But then looking at it from the other side as a consumer, nobody wants shoes that they could easily obtain at one point to then become limited. So we'll see how Adidas chooses to go forward with this. So Adidas and Gucci are back for round two. So this collaboration is coming off the heels of the Adidas Balenciaga collaboration, which was highly controversial to say the least. So let's see if they can live up to the expectations. I feel like after the very first collection, people were somewhat underwhelmed, I would say, overall. So we're gonna skip past the clothes and kind of just focus on the footwear. Remember, the new Adidas CEO did say that they do wanna, you know, own in on classics like the Special, the Gazelle, and Sambas, which they feel like are the hottest shoe on the market right now. So let's take a look at what they have to offer here. So I'm not a huge fan of this silhouette, actually, from Adidas. So by just throwing up the Gucci stuff on here, it's not really gonna change my mind. Keep in mind the price points on here. We're talking Gucci prices versus Adidas prices, which I feel like I'm not a big fan of when these high-end designers collab with more affordable brands, but then they still hit you with the high-end prices. I feel like the whole point of a collab, of course, is to bring attention to both brands, to kind of infuse a mixture of both fans and bring them together. But I also feel like you have to find a common balance when it comes to the price point, which is why I think Ye had a huge fight with the whole Yeezy Gap engineered by Balenciaga. He was trying to bring almost what we were gonna get with Balenciaga, but at a more affordable price, because by just hitting us with the higher retail prices, it almost gatekeeps this fashion from everyone being able to enjoy these designs. So here we have our first Gazelle colorway, and these are cool. Let's see what else they have to offer. So you have a blue pair, which the blue is definitely very vibrant. I think it stands out. I'm a fan of the translucent sole. So here we have the classic Gucci monogram. This looks similar to what we had from the last drop, I believe. So I'm guessing that because this one is that classic 10 Gucci monogram print. This one will probably be the standout and most high in demand out of all of the footwear. This one's a little more loud, I would say, more for the ladies with the pink on there. And you got a pair of slides, which they're not my cup of tea, but I could see the ladies pulling this off. You got a translucent slide. So I think this is more for the ladies, I would say. High platform. So I guess that's about it. I would say overall, when it comes to the footwear, nothing too crazy. I feel like when these brands, these sportswear companies, mix up with these high-end designers, the way to do it is kind of how Nike did their last collab with Louis Vuitton. You got to bring back a classic and infuse it with the designer. So I think doing it with the Gazelle is a great look, but I think it's a missed opportunity. They should have definitely threw in a Samba in there. And then again, speaking on price point, I think they should find some common ground in there. Instead of hitting us with a ridiculous, outrageous retail, which I'm not even sure right off the top of my head, the retail on these pairs, but I would say you guys shouldn't hit us with more than like $200 over the standard Adidas retail. That way you can make these pairs a little more obtainable to everyone. That way you guys can enjoy the design. So in terms of this collab, I'm staying far away from it. Nothing too exciting. I think they missed the ball by not doing a Samba here. And maybe they could even mix it in, threw in a Forum Low, which has been a more popular silhouette for Adidas as of lately. But again, I feel like this is just more of a repeat of what we got from the first Adidas Gucci collab. So not really for me. And we'll see how Adidas moves forward with the Samba. But I don't think anything they're doing right now can replace what they had with Yeezy. So we'll see how things go moving forward. Drop your thoughts down below. Salute.